show you how to play a very popular 80s song, Tommy Tutone's Jenny, sometimes known as 8675309. This song can be a little tricky, especially for beginners, but it's not that difficult. I'm going to go ahead and break down each part, then I'm going to play the solo along with the CD, and then I'm going to break that down as well. So to start out, it does a little picking pattern. It's going to be on your G, B, and E string. Now I will note, this song has a real strange tuning on the CD. It seems to be a semitone higher. I had to adjust this song in an application to play along with it. I actually took it down a semitone, and that's pretty close to standard tuning. But you should note that this song is in a slightly different tuning than standard. I'm not sure what happened there. It was probably done reel to reel back then, or some kind of tape, and when they did the final production, it took it up a semitone, or almost, I don't know, it's just a little weird tuning on the album. Okay, the first part of this song, which does have a little chorus, I'm using a H2O chorus pedal. I love the pedal. Visual Sounds makes unbelievable quality pedals. It actually uses an old style Roland analog circuitry, and it just sounds amazing. You want to start by placing your middle finger on the 6th fret of the G string, the 5th fret of the B string, and then you'll play an open E string. And then it will go up to the 7th fret on the G string, and then slide down to the 4th fret on the G string and 4th fret on the B string, the whole time keeping an open E. I'll go ahead and show you that pattern now. Okay. Now for the verse, it's going to be 4 chords. Each verse is going to be the 4 chords with a little lead parts throughout, and I'll break down the lead part. What the chords are going to be in the verse is an F sharp up to a D over to an A over to a B. And here's the rhythm for that. That's the main rhythm throughout the verses. All the verses are the same. And there is a little lead part, and you're going to play the same style. You're going to start with the same style fingering as you do the intro, but only play the G and B string. That's the 6th fret and the 5th fret. Then it's going to slide down to the 3rd and 4th fret. Then it's going to go to the 2nd fret on both strings, hammer on to the 3rd fret of the B string, then go over to the 4th fret on the D string, and then back to the 2nd. I'll show you. It's a little complicated to explain, but those are the frets, and I'm going to have the tab on my blog as well, but I'll go ahead and play it here so you can see what I'm doing. Like I said, it's a little hard to explain, but as you can see, it's not very complicated. The main part is just to get that rhythm down. Now, for the chorus, the guitar, it's going to come in right away, and it's going to start with an E, go down to a D, C sharp, A, then B. Then it's going to do the same thing, E, D, C sharp, and then back to a D. And it's going to do that twice. And that is how you play the chorus, and then it goes back to the rhythm with a combination of the intro. And then it'll go back through the verse using that little lead part I showed you at one point, and listen to the song so you know where to fit everything in. And then now it goes after the next chorus, it goes to a little bridge part. It basically starts with a C sharp, then it goes to an E, F sharp, A, and in B. It does that twice. And now it breaks into the intro and into the solo. So I'm going to go ahead and play the solo along with the CD, and then I'll break it down. And that's how you play the solo. Now I'm going to break it down. This is a real easy solo. Another great solo if you're just starting out to play solos. This is a good place to start and get the feel for it. What it's going to do is it's going to play the intro three times. Then on the fourth time, it's going to stop. Then it's going to play a little riff that starts on the fourth fret of your G string. Goes down to the second fret, over to the fourth fret of a D string. Second fret of the D string, fourth fret, back to the second. I'll go ahead and show you that little pattern right now. Okay, after that little pattern, what it's going to do is it's going to slide up to the 6th fret on the G string, over to the 5th fret on the B string, and then up to the 7th fret on the B string with a little hammer on to the 8th fret. And then it's going to go in a little pattern using the 5th and 7th fret on the E, 5th and 7th fret on the G, and 6th on the D string. So I'm going to go ahead and show you that little pattern right now. And as you can see, it ends with a little walk-up that you can see in a tab that I'm going to place on my blog. Rather than explain each individual fret there, I did it slow, you can see. But you can also go on my blog and download a tab to this song exactly how I'm playing it, so you can print it out and watch the video that will really help you out. And that's all the parts to Jenny. Like I said, they mix and match. They throw that intro riff into choruses, into verses. You have to listen to it. There's a lot of parts, but it's not that difficult, and the solo's actually pretty easy. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments, place them in the comments. If you have any questions, email me or PM me. I'll be glad to help. Like I said, the tab for this song is going to be up on my blog to help you follow along. And thank you for watching my video.